what you're doing at college, and this time. Frick!
I'm doing a little thing called work. We should try it sometime.
Are you challenging us? What happens to people who challenge us?
Oh, you bet I do. I know what you've been up to, and I have every intention to tell the police. In fact, why don't I do it now? I've got a mobile phone on me. I could ring them right this minute.
Yes,
I didn't. It'll be all over the newspapers, the internet, it'll be everywhere. There'll be scientists queuing around the block to experiment on me right now.
I can assure you I've told nobody, neither of the doctors. The only people that know are myself, your father, the hospital staff, and those two idiots that you were found with.
You told the police, haven't you?
About what?
You know those two idiots I was found with? They tried to kill me. They nearly took my life. And they've killed thousands of other students too. They need to be stopped.
But it was just a terrible accident, do you not remember?
Believe it or not, Mum, I'm telling the truth.
Just how much Coronation Street have you been watching recently?
Not much, really. Believe it or not, Mum, I'm telling the truth.
Yes, and David Cameron's a good Prime Minister.
Why won't you believe me? Everything I'm saying is true. It's all true. And if you won't tell the police, then I will.
Well, go on then, you do that.
Fine then, I will. Hello, police. I'd like to report attempted murder.
Understand? That was too close. Far too close. I sense today's the day, but we have not prepared.
Then surely you should look towards the future, Master.
Perhaps I should, but first, we must prepare. Otherwise, we shall only fail while others succeed.
Hey, Colin! No sign of Rose?
No, but listen. There's something really strange going on in there. Like, I tried to go into the drama classroom, and the door just shut in my face. And I tried to go into the studio as well, and the same thing happened.
I wouldn't worry. Probably just Jason lagging about. You know what he's like.
I didn't think of that, but it's something else.
What's that?
I just heard two voices, but there was nobody else here until you came along.
Okay. Well, in that case, I would worry. And I mean, really worry.
Gordon, I can safely assure you I am not going mad.
You're hearing voices, Colin. If that's not a sign of madness, I don't know what is.
The boy has heard.
Did you just hear that?
Hear what?
That voice.
What voice? Colin, are you sure you're alright?
You mean not mad? Yeah, I'm definitely sure. I definitely heard a voice.
Don't you dare tell me Parson's something real. I don't fancy being paralysed by a basilisk.
Me neither.
So, do you want to try entering the classroom again?
Well, what else can I do? I could hardly skip class. Toilet? It was a long way.
You have to cover someone else's note.
Now is the moment.
Master, there's something you need to know. It's urgent.
Space, I'm busy.
Shut up and listen.
I can't.
But Master... I can hear you, you know.
Colin, is everything alright?
Can't you hear them, Rose? The voices. Don't tell me you can't hear them either, Rose.
There are no voices, Colin.
Who is? I can hear them wherever I go. The same two voices.
Anyway, as I was saying...
Answers.
Oh, don't worry, boy. I will. Hello, boy. Are you ready?
For an explanation? More than ready.
Then let's begin. As you already know, I am time of the fourth dimension.
Just get on with it. I don't need to be reminded what I already know.
Patience, boy. As I was saying, I am time. My importance rings across the entire cosmos. Even the planet with the most primitive life need me in order to survive. But my importance has some drawbacks. There are people out to get me. One of those who works at the college you go to.
Rose!
Precisely. Rose is after the youth that you hold within. However, should she possess it, I will cease to exist. So do you.
But why? How would that kill me?
I chose you to be the one living thing on the planet Earth that is unable to die. But in order to do it, I place a piece of me inside him.
But you mean, Horcruxes are real? J.K. Rowling was actually telling the truth. But that makes you Tom Riddle!
Boy, we don't have time for discussing fantasy books. I am not Tom Riddle.
No, you sound more like Vernon Dursley.
This is not important, you foolish being. There are people out to get me, and all you are thinking about is Harry the Bloody Potter.
Sorry.
So you should be. As I was saying, I placed a piece of me inside him. Should I be killed, we shall die together. You are me, and I am
so,
you.
So long as you never die, I shall always be immortal.
Well done, boy. You're learning quickly. I am bodiless, therefore I have no form of protection. Meanwhile, you have a body, and therefore your immortality is forever protected, unless somebody should dare to kill me.
But why do you even need an immortal being?
Because otherwise I'll be killed immediately. You bloody idiot. I need somebody who is able to live as long as me. Should I never be destroyed, you shall be my guardian. Your first job is to deal with Rose. Be careful. Rose also has a protector.
That must be the bullies I encountered earlier. But why did they murder all those people? What did they do to deserve that? Why did they want to give me the same punishment?
They found out Rose's intention, of course. Why else do you think Rose would want them dead? They thought you had found out the same information.
I wish I had. It would have certainly saved a lot of time.
Do you use correct grammar, boy? Love off does not make sense considering there is only one of me.
Fine. Save time then. Is that better, Your Majesty?
Out of all the rude, inconsiderate things to call me.
You really are particular about language, aren't you?
Boy, anything other than the Queen's English makes you look like a small ignorant fool.
Oh, I do apologise, Your Lordship. May one please speak how one wants to without being hit by snide remarks all the time?
One denies your request with pure hatred. Anyway, I think we better get back on topic more. So those people who were murdered found out what Rose intended to do. Which means you have to tread careful ground. Once you find out Rose's intention, make sure they don't find out you know.
And then I'll stop her from claiming my youth.
Precisely. Now stop Rose for me, boy. And quickly.
Soon, my normal friend will be touch. I can almost taste the enduring youth glowing luminously from wherever you come from. Delight it would be to be a child yet again. All the unbearableness of torturing that fourth dimension whose sheer arrogance is unbearable to even think about. And yet, I feel slightly guilty for the boy I knew in the youth form is a curse. And of all the population, why a child? Why did he choose a curse, such an innocent being? If I was time, I would have chosen a murderer, or even a normal middle-aged man. It seems somewhat unfair to use that boy. If there was another way, I would pursue it, but there is not. I must possess the boy's youth, for then time will cease to exist, and eternal youth will be mine.
Doing, boy?
Trying to do wolves. What do you think?
She might not even be in there, you stupid fool. Teachers don't come off an idea, you know. Do you think the teachers are homeless or something?
It is a classroom, and if wolves is as bad as you try to make out, I doubt you'd think twice about trying to clear the classroom as a fortress.
Well, boy, your dumb deduction was right.
I thought they were just stories, you know, made up by my parents.